Welcome, foolish mortals.
So, I've printed these pages off, and these are on Mike's website, digital downloads that you can purchase. Graves Anatomy. I have put them into my own, not my own, but my graphics program, and shrunk them to a size that I know will work for this page. I'm going to tear fragments of book text. I'll get that in. I want it to be this isn't strictly speaking book text, but that's what I'm using, so. Something like that. Oh, and my printer's running out of ink, that's why it's a bit of a funny colour. It should be more that colour, I believe. And as you can see, it ran out, so it doesn't matter. This one. I did try to spray it with a bit of fixative, but I'm running out of fixative as well. So, it's not probably gonna still bleed, but I'm okay with that. So we'll stick with this slightly greenish colour tone to the page, which will work quite well actually for this page. I think, is that enough? Yeah, let's just tear this last little bit off as well. Might as well. Here we go. Right. Let's see where we want to position these. I think that's fine. Okay, so let's get the good old matte medium. Move this one side slightly. Okay. This is just mixed media paper. Way too much matte medium on. Yep, that's bleeding quite a bit. looks like I'm going to be on track for my 7 days of Halloween. I've got some videos editing, well, a video editing right now. I'm going to try and get as many edited today as possible. I only managed one so far. That's just exporting into my folder for videos now, and then I can upload it to YouTube. Got a lot to do today though. I'll try and get these videos filmed and put some washing away and cook some lovely dinner because it's Sunday and I really want a nice Sunday dinner. There we go. So I'm going to let that dry. It's going to be a bit bumpy and wrinkly and textured, but that's okay. Right. So I'm going to let that dry. I'm going to get the oven on, I suppose. I'll be back soon. Okie dokie. So now that's dryish, I'm going to grab a baby wipe and some neon green. We're just going to add a bit of a colour to sort of bring that all together. Nice slime green. Look at that. That's great, doesn't it? Oh, I'm loving it. Push that into the background and dump it down nicely. So let's give that a quick blast and we will move on to the next step. Right, okie dokie dokie. So for the doodling, doodles and tangles or scribbles, I'm going to doodle. Should I do it this side? I think this side will show better. Just in this corner. Not really a doodler, but Halloween page. Doodle or spider's web quite easily. What are we going to do next? Do I have my focal point? sure about yet. I may just cheat and distress the edges. I think I know what quote I want to use. It doesn't include any of the words again, but it's in my head whilst I'm doing this page, so it's going on there. Sparkle, shine, stamp, oh, stamp. Well, I do want to stamp my main image. Do I want to stamp anything in the background also? Possibly. I'm just trying to think in my head what stamps I've got that might work with this. Yes. So let me grab my stamps and be right back. So I have Mr. Bone Jangles from Visible Image. And I'm going to grab him. My skeleton. And I think I want him in a couple of places around the page. Oh, he's so sticky. I had this problem last time I used him. Sticky stamp. Okay, that's okay. So let's quickly link him up, get him stamped. Oh, there's pink, green paint on him now. Stamp. That's okay. To be honest, I don't think I want exactly perfect images because this is just part of the background again. Magnets. Just one more. Right. Whilst we've got the stamping press out, we may as well do our focal image. Paper. I don't think I have any scraps left, so I'll use this. Jim Holt stamp. Stamps Anonymous from the Monstrous set. And I love, love, love these stamps. Just, look how clear he is. I'm just going to go over him once more. There we go. I just had an idea. Okay, so the prompt was to stamp with ink or paint. So I'm going to grab some paint. I'm going to stamp with that too. So pop Frankie to one side, pop the stamp press in there. Ooh, sort of, which I'll get under there. right. Now then. Page back. Grab some paint. Ooh, right. And we want some purple. Purple. Ooh, shall we do it? Let's use metallic paint and that will get our sparkle or shine in there. So I need this. Whoopsie. I need my pen. Let's pop that back before I lose it. Squirt out some metallic purple and purple. Let's grab some bubble wrap, scissors, here's the scissors. Go in random places. Together, very nice for this page. Now let's have some going over the edges. There we go. Now, I need to let dry, so let's grab Frankie. Let's put that to one side. And I'm going to grab my pencil crayon, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I have my Faber-Castell pencils. Sort of sickly green colour. Very sickly green. Oops, that didn't go in at all. Is that some lighter green? To blend it all together. Sorry, excuse my head a second. Try and get these crayons back in there. And then we've got sort of a silvery colour. What colour do I do with eyes? Maybe go with this that one, just a hint of colour there. Yes. So right, so I'm just going to cut him out and I'll be back in a sec. Okay, so I did have a tool. He just rolled along and it's got stitches on it, but I don't know. I think I might have left that at my fiancé's house. So I'm thinking it might be kind of fun to do some proper stitching. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my pokey tool. And, oh, I've got some foam here that I can use to poke into. And I'm going to poke some pilot holes. Stitch into. Just had a thought. I was going to just stitch, but it might be fun to do some stitches across. So we'll do two rows that run parallel. There we go, and then I need to find some needle and thread. So hopefully that won't take me long. I'll be right back. So I've got this thread that's quite thick. We shall use that. Just cut a bit off. Right. Let's see, shall we? Quite a long tail, because obviously if I knot it, it would just come through anyway. Okay, I'm not sure you can really see that very well. So what I'm gonna do is just pull that out. Oops, I've got a knot in it now. I'll double it over. And these two strands, and stop at that knot. Should be enough. That one. Let's tie that off. I'm no surgeon. That's gonna be a bit short, so we'll get rid of that. Keeping an eye on the time. So go and sort dinner out. Okay, that's not it then. Thank you. Sorry, I'm waving it about in the air. Pretty windy out there today. It's not too cold though. The rain clouds keep coming over, threatening to rain and not raining, so hopefully I'll be able to dry my cardigans off. They were outside on the air because I didn't want to stretch them. They're sort of stretched over the air. There we go. Quite like that. I know it's not standing out very prominently, but it's there. It's a bit of interest. And it matches with the page's theme. Scribbly bits. Right, now I wonder if I have a chipboard frame that would be the right size. Let me have a look. Okay, so die cut a black frame and I've just popped out a little bit of gold. This is titanium gold from Artiste, Do Crafts Artiste. So, pop that away, and dip my finger into the paint, and spreading that out. I think this is a Spellbinder's die if you're interested at all. They're labelled eyes. All the rage when die cutting first hit the papercraft market. Right, now what did I do? There he is. I just have a look at this. Yep. Let's just put a touch more gold on. There we go. And move that out the way again. Here we go. Let's pop him. Used Elm's glue just because it's there. A bit clogged up, there we go. Right. Now I'm going to add in my quote. And I'm going to use a black pen. I use quite a thick one. Smaller one. I don't really want to handwrite this, but that's what it says. I wonder if I have a good stencil that can help me out. I'll use a smaller pen and then go over it when I've got it all planned out. So we've got our quote there. I realise I'm not sure if that should be then or when. When my monster from his slab began to rise. I think it's when, but then will do. So hopefully you know what song that belongs to. It's my favourite Halloween song. A classic. It's from the Monster Mash, if you don't know. I don't know why, it was just... As soon as I saw the colour green and the Halloween theme, I thought of Frankenstein, and then... Yeah, I don't know, just the monster, just kind of... That quote just kind of stuck in my head, so that's why I've gone for that. Just gonna... firm up some of those letters, I think that's fine now. And we're going to add a little bit of the vintage photo as the damp earth colour that we've got on our suggested colours. Just see if I've got a sponge. Yep, here we go. Sponges. I'm just going to go around the edge with this. So I think that can count as our frame. So let's go through the list. Glue, torn, fragments of book or music text. Yes, I did that. Stamp with ink or paint. I did both, I stamped. Skelly in the background, and I stamp my little paint splotches. Add doodles and tangles or scribbles. I doodled this spider's web in the corner here. Add stitches or staples. Well, I added some stitches to the page, which was kind of fun. Next, include a focal point or two or three. We've got our Frankie there. Frankenstein's monster, I know. Include a frame or border of your choice. Yeah, we put a frame on there. And we're bordering the page with this vintage photo. Add phrase, quote, or journaling by hand. Well, hand? I did it by hand. I mean, I may have used a stencil to help me, but I still by hand. That's what I'm saying. And add small elements of sparkle or shine. Well, we added that metallic paint, and we also added some gold to the frame, just to give it that antique look. Oops, let's just go around the edge. I like a nice dark edge sometimes. And the colours, slime, purple and damp earth. I think I've done that. And we didn't use any of the suggested words. Creepy, screaming, raven, trick or treat. But there we go. And that is my, excuse me, Jack. Let's pop Jack up there, shall we? That is, let's get that in frame and zoom in a little bit so you can see. Here we go. We'll zoom in and then I'm going to show you around a little bit. Look at that, guys. Wasn't that fun? So, I hope you have enjoyed my 7 Days of Halloween series. It's been real good fun. I've loved some of the pages that I've made. And I hope you enjoyed the Mission Inspiration and you join Mike and everyone over on the Facebook page, which I will link below. And thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you soon. Bye bye, guys.